And right now, Hamilton County is seeing all-time highs in active cases and patients in hospitals. Thanks so much for joining us here at 6 o'clock. I'm Tanya O'Rourke.
And I'm Craig McKee. This is bringing a strain, of course, to the healthcare system, already worried about what comes next. WCPO 9 News reporter Larry Seward has the latest.
It's a swab of concern. New stats show Hamilton County broke a single-day record for active COVID-19 cases, 1,472 cases, twice the previous high in December 2020. Worse, the number of people in hospitals hit an all-time high, too. Countywide, more than one in every four people tested for coronavirus are positive.
I'm not certain there may be a slight spike in that zip code, but in general, every single community in Hamilton County, east side, west side, north side, everywhere has a significant spread of COVID right now. We know that it's spreading rapidly, and we know that if you're not taking precautions, it won't be long before COVID catches up with you.
It's even true for frontline workers. UC Health's chief executive sees higher percentages of staff infected or quarantined. Just last weekend, 300 a day took tests over health concerns. They are short-staffed, worn down from months of double shifts and overtime, while facing demand that periodically forces the hospital to close beds.
This pandemic is not over. In fact, it is heating up more and more intense than it ever has been in the entire almost 2 years that we've been wrestling with this.
Trying to avoid the onslaught crippling healthcare systems in Cleveland, local public health leaders repeated old pleas for masking, social distancing, vaccination, and booster shots. Without it, they think record-breaking trends continue.
Is any of this unreal to you? And what does it say that we are using those descriptors at this point in the pandemic?
It's astounding to me that these numbers are so high. It's a wake-up call. We need to practice what we know works, which is staying home when you're sick, masking, and keeping a safe distance.
Larry Seward, WCPO 9 News.